take a sip of my LaCroix. I love this drink. It's so amazing, okay? I literally drink them all. I think I've had all the flavors. But anyways, hey, 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 and welcome back to my channel. It is Ashleigh here, and if you are new, hey girl, hey. So in this video today, I'm going to be sharing with you three super cute, inexpensive wall decor pieces. So let's get started. Okay, so what you're gonna need is three of these wood clip frames that you can get from Michael's for 99 cents a piece. And then all you're gonna do is you're going to remove the clip at the top. So this clip in particular popped off really easily, but I'm not gonna lie to you and tell you that they're easy to pop off because some of them are a little bit difficult than the rest. But then after that, you can have some clips for chips. The next thing that I'm gonna do is I'm just going to putty up each of the holes, and then I'm going to sand that down using some 220 grit sandpaper. The next step is painting, so I'm just using this apple barrel paint, and I chose some springish vibe colors, and I'm basically just going to add the paint to each piece. Now I'm gonna do like a purple one, and then I'm gonna do the peach color, and then I'm gonna do a pink one as well. So you can paint these whatever color you want. If you don't wanna paint, you can also stain these as well. All right, so I created some stencils in Design Space, and now I'm going to just cut them out with my Cricut. And what I'm using is a removable matte black vinyl, and I'm gonna let my Cricut cut out my designs. And then I am going to use my scissors and cut off the excess pieces that I don't need. And then I'm gonna use my so-called weeding tool. Literally, this is like the tooth, like the little toothpick thing that you can get from the Dollar Tree. And I am weeding out what I don't need. So the cow and then my outline of this. And now I've just created a removable stencil that I'm gonna use for this. All right, so now I'm going to add my stencil. And to do that, first I tried to do it with transfer tape, but when I did that, it totally didn't work and it like ripped off and it just wasn't working for me. So I just flipped the stencil over once I carefully peeled it off, made sure it was centered, and then I took my other piece and I pressed it on top. And then when I flipped it over, my stencil was on there, nice and perfect. So now I'm just gonna take my fingers and I'm smoothing around just to make sure that when I paint, I don't have any paint seeping through. So if you don't have a Cricut machine, you can get any pre-made stencil and do this, or you can do the other transfer method where you print the picture out and then you take some water and your paintbrush and you go over the picture and then you trace the picture with the end of your paintbrush and it will transfer onto your wood. If you do have a Cricut, I will try to have these files down below, so make sure you click on this. Oh my gosh, make sure you check out the description down below to see if I have those links, because I'll try to figure out how to do that for you. But anyways, after that, now I'm just going to paint my stencil, and I'm using sheepskin, and I did about two coats to each stencil, and then I just remove the stencil, and if it tears, it doesn't even matter because you can just, you know, buy some more removable vinyl and make you some more stencils. Next, I'm just gonna take a small little paintbrush and the paints that I used, and I'm just going to clean up the areas where either paint got removed or it seeped through. Okay, so now comes the fun part, and you get to decorate the inside of each of your animals. So honestly, I got this idea from these decor pieces that I saw in Hobby Lobby. They were a farm animals, and then they had like flowers in the inside, and I thought it was super cute. So now that's what I'm doing, but these are like miniature versions. So I'm just taking the paints that I had and I am using my smaller paint brushes, and I'm gonna start to draw like some leaves and different types of flower shapes inside of each animal. Okay, so now I'm gonna take these beads that you can pick up from Michael's, and I'm going to be threading them on a piece of twine. So you can do whatever pattern you want. So once I got my pattern down packed, I created three more of these, and actually not three, two more of these, and then I'm going to add them to the back. So here I'm just using my hot glue to add it to the back, which is perfectly fine. You can add your hot glue, but I will also recommend using like a heavy duty stapler. So if you have a heavy duty stapler, you can staple this to the back as well. My stapler, I literally, this staples that I had were way too long, so I didn't use them. But then after that, you're just going to snip off the excess twine, and then that is it for this. Okay, so I'm loving how these turned out. My favorite is the chicken. Honestly, I was gonna do wood frames with these, but I decided not to, and I saw some signs in Walmart, so that inspired the wood beads at the top of these. So these are perfect for the spring. They're also super, super cute to add in a nursery, and you can do farm animals. You can do whatever animals you want to, and add the flowers as well. And honestly, I just think that these would be adorable in a toddler's room or a nursery. Alright, so that's the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, as always, make sure you give this video a big thumbs up. Make sure you comment down below to let me know what you think. If you're not subscribed to my channel, make sure you click on that subscribe button and you hit that notification bell, and I will see you in my next one. Bye! Oh my gosh. I literally held that burp in until the end. But anyways, I will see you guys in my next video. Toodles!